Hello, ladies and gentlemen. It's Mike here at Game for Scratch. Today, we're talking about the UNIGINE game engine. Now, this one really came to my attention earlier this year when they finally launched an indie developer-friendly version, Unity Community. It allows you to use it for free up to a certain amount of revenue. It really makes UNIGINE much more viable for indie game developers. And then in April, they launched UNIGINE 2.11, and now today we have UNIGINE 2.12. Now, that doesn't sound like much. 0.01, you don't get much in that, but actually, you're getting a heck of a lot. I want to knock your socks off here. So if you're not wearing socks, go grab some. Come on back and let's continue. All right, so here you can see UNIGINE in action. This is the UNIGINE editor going on, and you can see some nice shadowing effects going here. And this is actually kind of showcasing some of the new features and functionalities in this particular release, including this whole demo. This is the wildfire demo, completely new sample that they've added. But you see here, we got some environmental haze in the background. We've got these nice shadows going on here, and that is because of changes to their particle system. Oof, we've got a heck of a fire going on here. And this is a demonstration of their new particle system. So as you can see here, this is a beautiful engine. The performance is great. By the way, I'm running this on a Razer Blade laptop 2019, GeForce 2070. I'm going to try to remember to say that stuff as much as possible when I do these videos. But you can see here all of the various different things that have happened in the new particle system, and there's a ton of changes to the particle effect systems. We now have translucent shadows available here, so that's what's giving us this ability over here. Some great looking shadows coming out there. We've even got some changes to the way that light maps work, sorry, shadows work from distance. We'll see that when we get into the release notes in a minute. But frankly, there is a ton that have been changed here. And it's not really, this one shows it off from the sexiest way of showing things. But I'm going to actually come over here and we're going to open up. This is the same example, by the way. I'll show you how to grab this in just a second. But we're going to go to the particles example instead. And I'm going to open up particles. And then which one is it? Curves, particles, curves. There it is, curves. So a couple of things have changed here in the particle effect systems. So here's a demonstration of them being controlled by curves. And these two examples kind of show it the nicest. So here's a particle emitter that we've got going on here, and off the particles go. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab the emitter. That's right, this guy right here. And we'll just bring this guy over here so you can see the properties window a little bit better. So one of the major new things you've got here, I've got a bunch of new controls over particle effects. We saw that one of the big things in the other example, that fire effects, there's now emissive capabilities. It gives you the ability to have like a fire and smoke transition all in one. And the cool thing is everything can now be controlled with this new curve editor. So this example, we're controlling X, Y, and Z values here. So we're controlling a vector in action instead of, you know, RGB alpha, but it can control a variety of different things. So here's your legend on the side. So X, Y, and Z, is the red is the X, and we can grab a point at any time, and there you can see immediately the effects like so. And again, we can coordinate all three of the axes can be edited, and here's the Z finally. So we got this new curve editor for controlling particle tools. On top of that, we've also got the new again, emissive abilities there. We've got some new translucent shadows going on with these guys. So there's definitely some major improvements to the particle effect systems. We've also got some really big ones behind the scenes, especially if you're using the C-sharp programming language. But another thing that's real eye candy thing before we move on is we've got also improvements to their sky system. I'm not going to show you specifically the release notes kind of get into the details, but just in case you're wondering, look at this. This is, it gives you an idea of the graphical capabilities of the Unity engine. We can do procedural clouds, and then boom, there we go. We just created some procedural clouds, fully animated. You can see them moving as they go. The clouds just got quite a few improvements with this release as well. So if you wanted to check this stuff out, I'm going to show you a couple of things, and we're going to hop into the release notes. I got to also give them kudos. They do excellent release notes. So here we are in the UNIGINE SDK browser. This is basically their Unity Hub or Unreal Launcher or Epic Game Launcher. It's kind of a coincidence, too, that all of these engines start with UN. So we got Unreal, Unity, and now we have UNIGINE. So the next one coming along is going to be UnSomething. So here we see you want to go ahead and install it. Products, go here to the version, make sure that you're running 2.12. And then we've got under the add-ons, one of the improvements we've got here is all of the VFX examples have been updated. So they use the new particle tools. So they're using the curve editor and emissive lights, especially in the fire examples here. So if you want to add some explosive packs or whatever to your thing, you can add those as an add-on. That's basically available here in your project. You're going to notice here, I did an example here. So you can add them in when you're creating them. just basically drag the VFX pack over. On the topic of add-ons, we've also got some improvements to this one. So this vegetation pack is a collection of trees, shrubs, grasses, etc. that you can use in your examples. It got updated as well. So there's a ton of new content in that vegetation pack if you want to add that kind of stuff in. Now, the samples I was talking about that showcase the new particle effects, those are all available in the demos sample. So just go in here and download and run the art samples. That's what you just saw in action. And that's what includes that new forest fire example. So you want to jump in and see the new capabilities in action, and you want to try it yourself, probably the best way to start. Another two key ones here, if you're doing some C-sharp programming, start with the C-sharp component samples. You can download them here. And if you're looking to do a game, looking for a game template, you're going to want to start with this guy. And then we've got three of them here for VR. Probably want to start there if you're doing VR development. But this example right here kind of showcases how to use, how to create a third-person game. I used this example in the last video I did about UNIGINE. So if you want to check that out, it is available there. But the big things that we changed here again, all the new updates are here in the add-on pack for VFX. It has been updated to use the new particle tools. And yeah, so basically that is the update here. So you can see the editor in action. We got some cloud improvements. We got a bunch of particle system improvements. Got a bunch of editor tools. And there's a bunch of smaller tweaks across the board. So now we're going to jump in to said release notes. So here we go. Again, I will link these in the linked document down below. So if you want to learn a bit more. There's actually quite a bit to cover here, so I'm going to skim over most of it, but we've covered a couple of these things. So basically, particles improved, definitely. So the big star of this update is improvements to the particles. Various control parameters enabling you to control the value for the whole life cycle of the particle itself. We saw the curve editor in action. You can change, for example, here you can see they're doing RGB updates over time, and there you can see as you know you can control all three of those values as time goes on. It gives you the ability to easily make things like fire effects, especially when we combine it with the new emission capabilities. And you can also do it with things like the X, Y, and Z, like we saw in action with the particle example I showed earlier on. So the new curve editor is definitely a nice feature. We've also got motion texture support. These are basically texture atlases that can be brought in. Now, I did a thing on Embergen just a few weeks back. If you want to check that out, it's a really cool fire and fluid simulation system. And it ultimately outputs these texture atlases, which now UNIGINE supports the motion texture support. You can also create these using Houdini if you want. And there you can see the end result of having motion vectors turned on and not. So they've done a really great job with this release notes, by the way. So here, let me zoom out so you can see the whole thing. So here we go. Emissive, again, you can now have light sources being given off by your particles. And here you can see a really drastic example of what you can do with that. So if you want to have explosion effects, you could have your same smoke effects basically at some point in their lifestyle, which you, again, could control using that curve editor. You can give off these various different lights at different times. So you can do some really cool effects with the emissive effects. And we saw, again, the translucency of particles, which you can control on a per material basis via the translucence texture. We saw this in action with the forest fire. All those basically clouds were being, or the smoke billowing smoke clouds were causing the shadow on the ground. Definitely a nice new improvement there. And we've got a couple of other improvements as well. And then we've got, including the albedo and emissive channels being controllable via curves. So we also saw X, Y, and Z and color. You can control those other values as well. We've also got some performance improvements. So the physics engine is twice as fast over the previous version. Twice as fast is never anything to complain about. And we got a couple of improvements there in context management and physics callbacks there. We've also got improvements to the landscape and terrain detail system. So this is for like putting your textures onto your terrain in the world. Bunch of improvements there, including the ability to control rotation and offset. So you can see it kind of, this is the same texture being rotated around in the world. So you've got control over that kind of thing for your materials coming in. Detail masks dithering. You can also control dithering for detail masks of landscape terrain to remove artifacts. You can see the various different effects and what that does to your terrain as a result of it. And then a bunch of smaller improvements to the terrain tools as well. As I mentioned earlier on, clouds got a lot of improvements. Probably the biggest one is this new horizon. So the world is not flat. At least 99.9% of sane people believe that. And what you can see here is we've got curves disabled. So the current system works like this. Now watch down here, because the reality is horizons curve off as you go. And now we've got, see, the clouds are more realistic in the way that they arc because they now take curving into action if you want. We saw this a little bit in the fire example, at least I think we did, and we now have physically based hazing, as you can see right there. Haze now works correctly with clouds with default settings, providing a realistic look out of the box. So if you want hazing in your world, it's there in 2.12. We've also got tiling free clouds. So there's a new tool, simply enable fix covering tiling via settings render clouds, and you can get You don't get the tiling effect that you could get in the past in large open worlds. On top of that, we've got a couple of cloud improvements, including the attunation coefficient. This one's very subtle. Basically, you can control the transparency or the solidity of your cloud. So you can see, look at right here. You can really see it when I bring it over. So the higher attunation is on, and there you go. Next up, we have some work in progress features in clouds as well. A research branch included improvements to the clouds, including support for, I'm not even going to say that, and the weather system in general, including a major upgrade of regional weather system effects. That's going to be coming in 2.13 or later. We've got some animation improvements here. So more advanced and convenient control over skinned mesh animations is now available. Each bone of a skinned mesh can now be bound to a separate node to track its transformation, giving you a lot of flexibility. Then we've got looped animation smoothing. You can see the effects for that off and on. Obviously, it's going to be more pronounced when the loop actually happens. So you'd see he kind of went twitched when it got to the end of the looping. So there you can see nice smoothing there. Material loadings, we've got a couple of different options for how materials are loaded to control. You know, it's all trade-offs. So, you know, it's going to have a spike in performance versus other options there. Now you've got the choice between no caching, caching for materials, and caching for materials and shaders. Obviously, you're going to have a trade-off of startup time versus performance, et cetera, or consistency of performance. So one of those things to be aware of. We've got a bunch of new boot and splash and loading screens for all three different versions. They look nice. Don't really care too much. The config file stuff, the engine configuration stuff, has been split up into multiple groups to make it easier to optimize management. So now we have default, default.config, default.boot, default.controls, and default.user. Obviously, you can see what all the various different pieces are. Again, this will be linked down below. So if you want to get into the weeds about something that's here, it will be in the link documentation. We got specular anti-aliasing. Pictures has 1,000 words. Off, on. Pretty profound there. We've got ranges for screen space shadows. As I was saying, there's new features here. So basically, as you move in, the shadows will change based on the steps as you're going in here. So it gives you consistent image with shadows rendered for objects at any distance from the camera at low cost. Has become even better. You could now set different step size and threshold values for objects located near the camera and far away from it. Thus, full-scale shadows will be rendered for large objects located far away, while within close ranges, only shadows cast by small objects will be rendered. Especially useful for locations where details are required for both short and long distance ranges. That's one of those things that really shines with UNIGINE. It's great for these large open world style games. And one of those big, huge things that's kind of, you know, lost in the translation here is .NET Core 3.1 support was in there. Now, .NET Core was released by Microsoft back in December of 2019. So pretty quick response here. This is, it also is LTS, so that can be supported for 3 years. .NET Core 3.1 will bring better performance, better garbage collection, C-sharp 8 support, support for Windows desktop graphics using WPF and WinForms, and a bunch of bug fixes. Minimum required Visual Studio version is now 2019 for C-sharp projects. Also added support for JetBrains Rider IDE. That should be its own point, by the way. I've done a video recently on using Rider with Godot and Rider with the Unreal Game Engine. And more, Project Rider is basically turning into the IDE of choice for game development from IntelliJ. So we've got some updates to the character controller. The Y-axis now points forward for the from the player, simplified support for game pads, etc. Some changes to their C++ component system in refactoring things going forward. We got miscellaneous improvements to the engine across the board. And unfortunately, this next part is going to be only for the sim and engineering tier, or just the sim in some cases, and it's a shame this first one didn't make it in, because this is really cool. It's a new sample. It showcases using voxelized terrain so that you can do things like dig hole into your terrain. So you see here they're voxelizing the ground so you can actually have dynamic holes punched in your terrain. Unfortunately, the sample is sadly only for the sim version. So you see here UNIGINE editor updates, again the new curve tools in action, better presets management, a bunch of smaller editor improvements across the board. Again, we'll link this down below so if you want to get into the specific details. Multi-channel rendering and image generator updates. We've got, let's see what else going on in here. A sim SDK licensing change. This isn't going to affect a lot of people, but if you're working on a larger team on a sim project, you don't have to actually spend all of the money on the tooling. If you just need the engine or editor, there's a cheaper licensed version available. So you can have some people working on your project using a cheaper version of the engine, because they don't need the SDK and all the code and stuff behind the scenes. They just need the editor. It's cool to see that, and hopefully more and more people do this kind of this stuff in the future. I saw you showed you earlier case, the demos and samples were both updated. We saw the particle curves. There's also a particle materials update. This is all in that graphics demo I showed you how to get earlier, and the wildfire demo we saw in action. Really showcases some of the new functionality. Unfortunately, this again is engineering sim only, but there is a new add-on pack for tractors and construction site and airport. It's basically a bunch of prefabs you can use to create your own scenes. There's the new VFX, well, not new VFX addicts, but the VFX add-on was updated to include all the new curve-based workflow and as well as the emissive stuff for particle systems. The vegetation pack I showed you earlier is now updated with a set of trees, small plants, and different grass types. We've got a new multilingual website, a bunch of new C-sharp learning materials on their website and on their YouTube channel, in-place documentation. We've made the first efforts to provide you in-place API documentation for C# and C++ in Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code, and in Rider. It's definitely nice to see. It's really handy having that pop-up documentation directly inside of your editor. A bunch of changes to the documentation. And then we have a new landscape tool, Work in Progress. A lot of this probably not that useful to the majority of game developers because this allows you to bring in real-world things like OpenStreetMap data, streaming it, or from your own private source. So if you're linking to real-world data, you can stream it in using the new landscape tool, bring in height maps, et cetera, from these common sources like QGIS and OpenStreetMaps and various other things, and then have it render. But that's actually not included. This is still an R&D item. And again, not that relevant to most game developers. It's more of an engineering side of things. So anyways, that is it. That is UNIGINE 2.1. Two for a 0.01 update. There's a huge amount of stuff in there. Some real great improvements to the particle effect system, some great updates to the C# support to C# 8 and .NET Core. We've got the new curve editors, new cloud systems. It's just a ton in here, and animation improvements, etc. So I do have to admit, again, UNIGINE is probably the engine that I'm most excited about right now. It might be because it's a new and shiny toy, but I'm going to keep playing with it further, hopefully get something else, some more content up about it in the future. So let me know what you think of UNIGINE. A pretty huge update here, and it's getting to be a more and more attractive engine every day to me. All right, that's it. Talk to you all later. Goodbye.